So what I want to do is just a worked example, just between you and me, free response. Go ahead and try to identify all the functional groups in this molecule. So first of all, tell me, how many functional groups are there? Is it 3? Is it 5? Is it 7? Go ahead and tell me. Then go ahead and try to identify each one. And if applicable, tell me what the degrees are. So tell me if it's an amine, tell me that it's secondary or whatever. So go ahead and try to do that. Pause the video. And then let's go ahead and talk about how many functional groups and what they are. All right, so that was a little tricky. I think that it was even more tricky because I gave you some condensed formula in there, so it kind of threw you off a little bit. Students typically hate to work with condensed formulas, so if you didn't mind it, then good. So first of all, how many functional groups did you guys find? And the answer was 3, okay? Because I had this double bond, I had this oxygen over here, and then finally I had that iodine, okay? Now, some of you guys might be wondering, what about alkane? We learned that alkane's single bonds between carbons and carbons are functional groups. We talked about it. Actually, it turns out that alkane, I should have mentioned earlier, is the only one that we don't consider a functional group, because alkanes are the backbones for all of organic chemistry. So, and they happen to not be very functional. In fact, they barely do anything. So when we're talking about functional groups, we're talking about things that are different from alkane. So that would be these three things. So what was the name of this first one? This would be an alkene. Okay. What was the name of this one right there? This one actually gets tricky because I want you to name degrees too. So this would be an alkyl halide. And particularly, it would be a secondary alkyl halide. Why is that? Because it's attached to two carbon groups. The carbon here, remember that iodine, it would be named as a hydrogen. So I would count one carbon, two carbons. Cool? And then finally, what did you guys get for this last one? This would be ether, okay? Because this falls into the ROR category, where I have ROR and there's no carbonyls around, so this would not be like an ester or anything like that. Cool? So does that make sense to you guys so far? Hopefully this is helping you guys to reinforce all the groups that we just learned. So let's go ahead and go to the next page.